even that story about it. Over there is even more severe than here. And so erosion is taking place, and over there properties are being threatened. And there is a need for immediate action, especially over there, to protect the properties there before the next rain comes in. Otherwise, it's going to undermine the properties. Some of them will definitely collapse.
Basically, Pulle Lagoon acts like a reservoir during tide. What happens when you have high tide? Water cannot flow out. So for 6 to 10 hours, this basin has to contain water. It should have enough capacity so that it can contain water, so that when low tide comes, it can flow out. And if you can see the breakwater also, has not been modified. New bridge has been made. But evacuation passage is still small. And on top of it, breakwater has fallen down. So we are doing engineering design for breakwater also. So that when we have to bring a dynamic equilibrium in this hydraulic system. so that inflow and outflow can balance. And that will happen once we complete this project entirely. So that is the aim. And at the moment, we are concentrating so that flood does not happen in coming rainy season.
It's very embarrassing to our own intelligence that every year there's a budget allocation to do this job. And in the end, because of our habits, because of the fact that the drains do not have integrity and they are challenged, very antiquated. These are ancient drains. So we need modern ones in which we do not even seal the filter because we don't go underground. So capital involved in this kind of arrangement is huge. But the president has given it clear that it is expensive, but Ghana is giving beyond his tenure as president. These matters have been staring at us in the face since Kwame Nkrumah days. Government should go to say that it will cost us money and to pay off generationally. This is what we are about to do. So he said that this place is a receptacle for the water.
The Kwale Lagoon is supposed to contain water once tide is rising.